हेलो गाइस, दिस इज मैक हियर। आई एम बैक विद अगेन विद अ न्यू वीडियो। टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर डिस्कशन फ्रॉम वेयर वी लेफ्ट यस्टरडे। वी सॉल्व सम प्रॉब्लम बेस्ड ऑन लिमिट, दैट वाज द प्रॉब्लम। वी सॉल्व सम लिमिट प्रॉब्लम ऑन लेफ्ट हैंड लिमिट एंड राइट हैंड लिमिट। वी सॉ दैट लिमिट मे एग्जिस्ट एंड मे नॉट एग्जिस्ट एंड हाउ वी विल डिफाइन इन मैथ लेवल। We can solve simply by giving limit command and function as an argument to the limit. But when we have to find the right hand limit and left hand limit, then we have to specify the f comma right into f comma left and the point of limit. Okay, by default it takes zero. Next we solve some problem on differentiation. We saw how we can solve the differentiation problem using MATLAB, and we solve some more advanced problem also, like higher power. Okay, now we again solve some higher order derivative problem. I took one problem that was very easy. We don't have to worry about how MATLAB will solve, yeah, how I will remember the mathematical multiplication rule of derivative or division rule of derivative. It will be more advanced problem. Then I have taken some problem today also, derivative problem. I have taken, this is the first problem. In is given, function is given, and we have to find f prime plus f double prime plus f equal to minus 5 cos 2x. And we have to find if left hand limit and right, sorry, left hand side and right hand side is equal or not, it holds true or not. Okay, then we will solve for second problem. It's given to find f double prime plus 2f prime. Okay, and after that we will solve some maxima and minimum problem, and we will find a stationary point, and I will tell what is stationary point and how we can solve it using MATLAB. Okay, let's move with the first problem. It's given 3 sin x plus 7 cos 5x. Let's take it and solve it using MATLAB. Okay, yeah, first we will define the variable x. Now put the equation. Okay, equal to 3. Don't forget to give multiplication sign, otherwise MATLAB will not work. It will throw error. Okay, 7 to go. Okay, this is our equation. This is our equation, y equal to 3 sin x plus 7 into cos 5x. Then we have to find f double prime. Let me see the question. It is f double prime plus f. Okay, this is LHS. Let's suppose it is LHS. We will say LHS equal to f double prime. That means we have to find the double derivative. Then I solved yesterday how we can solve the double derivative. Diff y comma 2 is double derivative, right? Now it is given f, that means plus y. This is our LHS. Then we will solve our RHS. RHS, what is RHS? Our RHS is minus 5 cos 2x. Okay, minus 5 into cos 2 into x, right? This is our RHS. And we have to see if LHS and RHS are equal or not, if it is hold true. Okay, let me remove this one, otherwise we will not get the answer in the command window. Look, our LHS is minus 168 into cos 5x, and our RHS is minus 5 cos 2x. That means both are not equal. Okay, that means equation doesn't hold true. Let's give some programming is equal. Is equal LHS comma RHS. LHS comma RHS. If it holds true, if this holds true, then we will display both are equal. Both are equal. Else display think not good. And after that, it will throw its sensor if it is equal or not. Then we will display the value. Okay. The value of RHS is, we don't have to show the value of RHS, because the value of RHS is already given, right? So how will display? It should be LHS. Now let's run the program and see if it is giving the answer what we are expecting. Yeah, it is giving not equal, and the value of LHS is this one. That means we have solved the questions, and is equal is taking the two argument binary. If it will return 1 or 0. If it will be equal, then it will return 1. If not equal, it will be return 0. Okay, and then at last we will display the value of RHS is this one. If it holds true, then it should give both are equal, right? Now we will move for the next question and we will solve it. Okay, very easy, right, to solve. 2 cos x minus 3 sin 2x. We have to find f double prime plus 2f. Okay, 2 cos x. Let me copy from here and paste it here. Okay, now we can remove it. You can try with me always, because it is good practice to solve together, right? So when I will start solving, you also open your MATLAB and start solving and try more problems, then it will be good for you, right? Okay, y equal to 2 cos x minus 3 sin 2x. Then we have to find f double prime, and then we will dip f double prime, that means f comma 2, sorry, f comma 2, right? Then what will be 2 f prime. Okay, 2 into f prime, that means diff f, that means we can simply give for single derivative. Okay, let's run it and see if we are getting the answer. Okay, unrecognized f. Okay, because we are not using f, right? We have defined since that. Sorry. Yes, this is your answer. You can try it manually also. MATLAB is very useful when you are solving more advanced problem or more complicated problem which you can't solve using pen and paper. This is very simple question. Even you can use your pen and solve it on your copy. Okay, but for more advanced problem, we can't take very advanced problem to solve for the tutorial, but you can also try. If you have any query, then you can post into the comment box, and then I will try to solve the question and will post the answer as soon as possible. Okay, now we have solved the LHS and RHS also. We have solved this both problem for derivative. Now let's move for our next problem, very interesting problem. We will find the maxima and minima using derivative and we will know what is the stationary point, what is belongs to, what it denotes. Okay, stationary point, if you have gone through the derivative, then you must know what is the stationary point. But let me explain what is stationary point. Stationary point is nothing but a point on a graph where the slope of a graph is zero. Slope, what is slope? That means first derivative, that means dy by ds will be equal to zero. Okay, now let's move for the first problem and we will solve it. What is our first problem? We have to find the point of stationary point, okay, and the point of maxima and minima, and also we have to find the value of maxima and minima. Now let's move with this problem. Okay, we will solve one by one, okay, step by step. Control V. Okay, this is the problem. 2x cube plus 3x square minus 12x plus 17. Okay, before moving to the problem, let's first try to plot this. Okay, is it plot y? Let's look how the curve look like for this equation, then we will move for our range. we have to find the local minima and maxima in the range minus 2 comma 2.
Okay.
Net is little bit slow. So, okay. This is our graph. This 3x square minus 12x plus 2x cube plus 17. This is the graph looks like. But we don't have to find for all over the range. We have to find only in the range minus 2 comma 2. Okay. So let's plot for minus 2 comma 2, minus 2 comma 2, okay, and let's see how it look like. Okay, this is the graph, this is the minima and maxima, we can see it here. Okay, at 10 it is minima and this point at kind 37 point something it is maxima. Okay, now let's solve it one by one. We have to find the maxima and minima or stationary point. What we have to do, we have to find first what, first derivative, and we'll equal put it equal to zero. Let's find, let's define g equal to diff for diff y. Okay, g will store the value of differentiation, right? Let's see if it is giving the differentiation. And we will check manually also. Okay, 6x square plus 6x minus 12. Let's try it manually. 3 will come ahead. 6x square plus 6x minus, yeah, it's right. Okay, 17 is constant, so it will give 0. That it's okay. We have calculated the differentiation. Now, this is a polynomial, right? G is a polynomial. And we have to put it equal to 0. We can put it equal to 0 manually. Okay, then it will become x square plus x minus 2 equal to 0, then it should give minus 1 comma 2. Okay, now let's solve. MATLAB will solve it for us because we don't have to worry how MATLAB will solve it. We will simply give solve g, then we will see the solution what it is giving, if it is giving the correct answer what we solve manually, minus 1 comma 2, right? Sorry, minus 2 comma 1. Yeah, it's correct, minus 2 comma 1. That means minus 2 comma 1 is a stationary point. Okay, when we will put the derivative equal to 0, that means 6x square plus 6x minus 12 equal to 0, then it should give the solution minus 2 comma 1. That means at minus 2 and 1 it is a stationary point. That means point of minima and point of maxima. Then we can see at minus 2 it is maxima and at 1 it is local minima, right? Now we have solved it. Now we will find the value. Okay, we will substitute the value. Okay, now let's say we can put it manually. We will put it manually, minus 2 comma minus 2 comma 1. We will put it manually in y and then find the value. What will be the value? We can see from the graph, but we will derive it from the equation only. Okay, now even for this MATLAB will solve for us, we have to use substitute command. Substitute, we have to substitute in y. First we will put 1. Now next we will put what? Substitute y comma minus 2 and let's see what value it is giving. Okay, that means 10 is the minimum value and 37 is the maximum value. Let's see from here. Yeah, what we derive from the graph, this is, yeah, 37 is the maximum value and 10 is the minimum value. We can even see from the graph and we can even see from the equation also. This is very easy, right? Let's see. Just try to display value. Display minimum value is It is good practice to put comment and put the display value, okay? Because then you will see at your code again. Then you can easily understand, right? Yeah. This is our total solution. This is our graph. We can see from the graph also, we can see from the equation also. Okay, now let's try for the next question. Our next question is y equal to 5x to the power 4 minus this is 54. Okay, 5x to the power 4. Okay, now let's try for next problem. We will do it here only, because no need to type again and again same thing. Okay. Instead of typing, it is good practice to understand the questions. Minus 4 into x square minus 1. Okay. Now plot for this one. We will see how the graph look like for this one. Same thing we will solve for this one also. Okay. Okay, this graph looks like very ugly graph is looking. Okay, not like the previous one. Okay, now calculate the differentiation for it also. Okay, now we will see. Okay, let me see. G equal to diff. We will not take the range for it. Differentiation. We will take the differentiation. Yeah. This is the correct answer, right? Now we will solve G. Let's see if we put the value equal to 0, then what it is giving. Oh, very different type of answer is giving, right? Minus 10 to the power 1 by 2 by 5 and a very complicated type of, but still we will see. Substitute and we will see what is the maxima value and what is the minimum value. Okay, y comma 0 0, y comma 9/5 and minus 9/5. Is it correct answer? It's maxima and minimum value minus 1, minus 9/5 and minus 9/5. That means its maximum value is minus 1 and minimum value is minus 9/5. You can try it for another range also, because very low range is giving. Okay. But this is the correct answer. Right? Now let's see if there is any other problem also. No, there is no problem. Okay, right. I hope you will try more questions on it. Okay, thanks for watching the videos. And please like and subscribe my channel. And please share it. And stay tuned for the next videos. In next video, we will solve the integration problem and more advanced problem. Thanks for watching the video.